Hi, I'm Jim Covington on behalf of the Illinois State Bar Association. Today is January 3rd, 2013. Happy New Year, and I'd like to welcome you to this, the first issue of this year's ISBA Statehouse Review. As you are following in the newspapers, the Senate is in session this week, and the House will be joining them on Sunday afternoon to finish up the remnants of the 97th General Assembly, and the new 98th General Assembly will be sworn in next Wednesday. There are four bills that I'd like to kind of talk to you about. The first one has been enacted into law, and it creates a new probate fee. It's Public Act 97-1093, sponsored by Senator Ira Silverstein of Chicago and Representative Sarah Feigenholz from Chicago. It creates a $100 fee to open up a decedent's estate to fund the State Guardianship and Advocacy Commission. It exempts indigents and some public entities, but it's to fund the State Advocacy and Guardianship Commission, and that is now law. It does a couple other things in the guardianship area for those of you who practice in that area, and you might take a look at the written summary that's on our screen as well. The second bill that I'd like to talk to you about is House Bill 5151, sponsored by Senator Jim Clyburn from East St. Louis. And it amends the Code of Civil Procedure to do three things involving medical malpractice and tobacco litigation. The first thing it does is that it repeals and reenacts the statutory provisions so that the text of those provisions accurately conforms to a couple of Supreme Court decisions in Best versus Taylor Machine Works and LeBron versus Gottlieb Memorial Hospital, if I'm pronouncing that right. I haven't had a chance to compare those, but that's what the bill is supposed to do. The second thing it does is it caps the contingent fees for plaintiff's lawyers in a medical malpractice action at 33 1/3% of all sums recovered. And the third thing it does is it limits the supersedious bond requirement for all of the appellants collectively in the tobacco in a tobacco settlement pending or future to $250 million. Senate Amendment Number 1, which becomes the bill passed out of Senate Executive Committee last night, is on the floor of the Senate now. The third bill I'd like to talk to you about is House Bill 4963. It's the bill to promote marriage equality, authorizing same-sex marriages in the state of Illinois, and that is sponsored by Representative Greg Harris of Chicago and Senator Heather Staines of Chicago. Senate Amendment Number 2 has been referred to Senate Executive Committee, and no action has been taken on that as of yet. The fourth and final bill I'd like to talk to you about is House Bill 30 that authorizes medical marijuana for patients who suffer from a, quote, debilitating medical condition, close quote, such as cancer, HIV/AIDS, or hepatitis C, to use and possess small amounts of marijuana if certified to do so by their regular physician. That bill will not be called for hearing in the 97th General Assembly, but I anticipate that bill will be refiled next year and heard again. And thank you for listening in, and we will talk to you later.